Welcome to RyanControl.com. In this video, we'll discuss about again a new automations use case in Confluence. Here we'll explain you how we can trigger an auto email whenever a new attachment will be added. So let's understand what's the exact use case and where we can use this automation. Let's say you have thousands of pages or document repository available within your organizations and you want to streamline your process whenever a big volume file will be uploaded in your instance, you will immediately get notified or administrator will immediately get notified. In that case, rather than doing manually, business always suggests to use automation. So Confluence automations will help us how we can auto trigger email whenever a new attachment is added. So we'll show you in detail within this video. If you want to learn more about Jira, project management, Confluence, feel free to refer my Jira and Confluence playlist. Even I have also created API and automations. You can also refer that too for more understanding and learning. And here I've created one of the course on Graphi, that is RyanControl.graphi.com. From there you can learn advanced concept of becoming or using Jira as a scrum master and project manager. I'll include all those URL in my description so that will be easy for you to refer. Let's get back to our automations. When you are building automation in Confluence, simply go to your instance, click on space settings. From here, we already have this rule. Now, what's the use case we are trying to build here? Again, I will repeat, whenever a new attachment will be added on any page, that should trigger auto email to the administrator. This is a file which is uploaded recently so that you can manage. Normally, this will always create conflict or problem within your instance where you have less size, or that will eat your lot of size when we are adding big volume attachments so that you can notify to the end user, hey, this cannot be done, or maybe you can upload in some other way to minimize the file size. Now, to build this automation, simply click on create rule. And this rule is suggest like attachment, whenever a new attachment added, I want to trigger an email. So send an email. Whom you want to send this email? I wanted to add my email ID. So you have include debug.dry. Add the weight at last year community. Maybe I will cross verify my email ID. I'm using very less, so let me check this. Yes, this is perfect. So I will copy and paste it here so that we'll get okay. Now, what emails we have? So here I wanted to add my page title and this. And whenever we are adding any dynamic content, we always make sure we can add interval parentheses. So page.title, and after that we can close it. Contain, what all contains I wanted to include here. So if I wanted to add space name, I will just specify space.name in double this URL. So here we'll add page.url. And after that, I wanted to add one more thing, page dot author dot full name. So this will give me author name to refer. And here, if you want, you can add your signature as well. Now, new attachment added, best regards. Confluence what? Confluence or automation. Click on save and this will ask me to enter email. So email notifications I will add. This will be available in private for me. Now, this automations rule is enabled. Let's navigate to any of this page. I want to include images. For adding the images, let me attach any image, maybe certificates of this. And you'll have the certifications, click on save, and that's it. This attachment is added. Let me go back to my email address and see if my inbox contains this image. Yes, I do have. So here we got the page title as subject, and here we have specified author name added, URL and full name of the author of the page so that we can trigger and exactly see wordings which we have specified. This is how we can automate this rather than doing manually, because for once and while triggering email to the individual users will be fine. But if we want to streamline and make sure that all those project repository are crystal clear, in that case, we should always use this automations. So what's the benefit of using this? We'll save a lot of time when we have big volume of images or informations to be shared with the individual user. Second, this will also help us our instance to be clean. And next thing is we can save a lot of space when we are managing all those stuff indirectly. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle and feel free to add your topic name if you want to learn from my further videos. I will try to come up with that topic. Thank you. Have a good day ahead.